Hey guys, so it's my 9 months in Peru, and when you are living so long time abroad, you have a big perspective on a lot of things. And I was growing up in Poland, so when I came to Peru and I'm living here, there is a lot of things which are weird for me. And what I'm kind of afraid that after so long time, because I'll be living here 13 months, I'll come back to Poland and those Peruvian things will be for me so normal that I'll see my own culture from this weird perspective. So that's why I'll tell you like those few things which maybe for you will be not so shocking if you grew up in culture similar to Peruvian one, but if you are from Europe, I'm sure those things can be kind of shocking for you. Starting from the first thing, and here's a little bit context. So when I was coming to Peru, I had my luggage and I was moving here, so I had a lot of stuff inside. Unfortunately, I had too heavy luggage. So on the airport, the lady said that, oh, your luggage is overweight, but it's fine, just remove something and I'll pass even if it will be more. And I was like, okay, so I opened my luggage and in the top of my luggage, I had cosmetics because I was going, I knew that I need to have something to start my life. So I had like shower gels, shampoos, all the stuff. And I was like, okay, so I'll remove shower gel. I don't need this, like I'll buy it in Peru, it's cheap. Like I was just used to having a cheap shower gel in Poland because we have a lot of like cosmetic shops and stuff. So I removed the shower gel. I came to Peru, I went to shop to buy my shower gel, and that was my first thing, weird thing in this country. The shower gels are so expensive here and you don't have choice. They're like few and you just don't, like it's expensive. Everyone is just using soap. I know that right now with whole like zero waste movement and stuff, it's a really good thing, but for me it was shocking. Like I was not get used to that. And then I start talking with my flatmates and I was like, okay guys, so what are you using for shower? And everyone like, soap. I was like, aha. Because I'm going from the culture and things which are available in Poland, it's like shower gel is something basic, just not here. So if you are coming to Peru, remember to pack your shower gel, because it's just expensive here, or you will just start using soap here. Next weird thing in Peru is about fruits. So I'm a huge fan of fruits. But there is one fruit which is extremely common in the world, which is orange, which is kind of different in Peru, because oranges in Peru are not orange. They're green. And if you wait longer, they're yellow. Of course, the juice will be still orange, but this type of orange is never getting orange on the skin. Once I found in shop like the orange, Spanish oranges, they were so expensive, like 8 times more expensive than normal oranges here. And oranges are super sour, they're not sweet, so prepare yourself for oranges here. When I'm talking about fruits, there is one more thing that I realized, that it's just weird in Peru. So if you are from Europe, you know that lemon is this big yellow fruit and then lime is the small one. But in Peru, names are just opposite for both of them. First, you'll not find lemon. I never saw this in shop. I heard they're just not here, they're not imported here. You'll find only limes. But in Spanish language, the lime is called limón, which basically means lemon. So just prepare yourself that the names are not how you get to use to those fruits, because they're just in different way in Peru. This thing is more about communication, and that was so shocking for me in first 2 months of living in Peru, and it's about Spanish and how the Spanish is used. So if you are in like Polish culture and you are meeting someone, say like, hello, how are you? And you are waiting for a response. And the person is saying, yeah, I'm fine, and how are you? But then in Peru, trust me, it's so common and it happened to me so many times that people are saying like, hola, que tal? And then they're starting talking more. They're not waiting for a response. So they're asking you like, how are you? How do you feel? And they're just not waiting for a response. It's just part of the way how they're communicating and saying hello. So it's like, it's just a sentence that they used to say hello. And I had so many situations that, I don't know, I was on the event and someone was hosting the event and the person was starting the whole speech. It was like from like, from just saying que tal, for me it was like, why? Why are asking like how someone is feeling, just not waiting for a response? It's like, for me it's something like a mixture of communication with the culture, which is just weird. Like, why you use that? If you are millennial like me, or you like healthy food, maybe you love sometimes to eat your avocado toast. I know, super millennial thing. And here in Peru, avocados are super common and they're part of your salad, like part of your dish, and it's everywhere. Trust me, avocados are everywhere here. But if you want to make your avocado toast, there's a weird thing. Avocados are just more cheaper than toast bread here. And yes, if you are paying, for example, right now, $5 for 1 kilogram of avocados, in the same time, you need to pay $12 for kilogram of the bread, like the toast bread, exactly the toast bread. So this is something what I just don't understand, because just toast bread is much more expensive in Poland than avocados. I know that they're import, but still, like, bread is super expensive here. And you need to be prepared that if you want to eat your sandwich, the bread will be not so cheap for it. If you are living in any country or you are just traveling, there is something basic that you just need to do, like crossing the road. And trust me, in Peru, it's just not easy. You need to get used to the way how you need to cross the road, because A, no one is checking the lights. B, you have like lights, you have the police officers directing the cars. And trust me, it's more like a game. We are always joking that going from our house to the office, it's a game to survive between like streets, how to cross them, because it's just not easy. You just need to figure out your own method, your own techniques, how to cross the road, and get to know that it's your time to cross the road. Time for the last weird thing, and it's everything connected with kuy, or in English is guinea pig. Everything which is connected to guinea pig here is just weird. Starting from that, it's so deep in the culture, and there is so many things connected with guinea pig that it's even hard for me to understand as foreigner. Starting from this, that this is animal which people are eating in Peru, that I'm in Poland, I'm used that that was a pet of my friends, that all my friends had guinea pigs, and here it's a dish which is very traditional one. But okay, with this I think I get to use, but there is thing that I'm not getting to use, to all the rituals with shamans about kuis, like guinea pigs, that it's used to take disease from you. There's so many rituals, and this you need to just research. I don't know so much, because maybe I just don't want to know, but in markets sometimes it's common just to find some shaman which can heal you with all your disease with kui. Just make your own research. I will not go deep in this topic, because I don't know this, and I think from my cultural perspective, something that I just cannot understand here. So just check it on your own. So those were things which are weird for me. There is much more. Those were like first thing that just came to my mind yesterday when I was sitting with my notebook, just noting down what was weird for me. I'm super curious, if you are living in different culture, what weird things does you notice there, and from your perspective, we're just weird in this country. And if you want to know something more about Peru, or you have some ideas what I can say and show you in the next videos, comment below. Remember to subscribe and click that like, because it will help me to create more and more and create cool content for you. So see you next time.